Since we have been able to register, now let us see how we can log in. You click the button login at the right here or by the left down here. So as you enter login, it's going to ask you your username, the username you use to register. You put it here. This is my own username. Then you type your password here. Then the same captcha number, that 6-character number, you retype it at the right. 555201. You type it at the right there. So once you have entered all those things correctly here, then you click login to account. If you have lost your password, you can easily click lost my password here. And thank God for this. This is what we call the second authentication. That is, this one is a security way. That is, if you log in from, maybe from different device, or you want to log in just to be sure that you are the one that is logging into your site. This information is that you have to copy a particular code from your email to be sure that you are the one that want to enter. So how you set that second authentication, I will show you when I log in into this web, into the dashboard. So here I have to copy my code from my email. So I have to check my email, the code that is being sent to me. Now, yes, the code that is being sent to me is A71CC7. Then you click submit. So that is second authentication for you to be sure that, for the system to be sure that you are the one entering. If you send information to your email, and that is when I can now come back to my dashboard. I told you that I want to show you how you can set that your second authentication. You just come here. You can see where it is written security, but towards the right hand side here. You click security. As you click on security, so that you can have second authentication. It is not compulsory if you know you don't need it, or if you know your money may not be secured enough if you don't use it, you put it. So you set this come to this place. If you have not set it, it will be on disable. Then you select paranoid and you select enable here. As you've done that, you click change setting. It means you have set your second authentication, and the email you use to register will be the one that will be receiving the code in order for you to log in. That is about second authentication. Now let us overview our dashboard as we log in. So your dashboard on the account as you log in. You can see the dashboard. First menu on top here, where you start deposits, transactions, referrals, transfer to members, settings, security layout. They are the menu on your dashboard. If you want to deposit, the deposit at the center here, that is bold at the center, is one you will use to deposit. And if you want to withdraw, the withdraw that is written in blue, in blue white out here, is the one that you use for withdraw. Or you click deposit and withdraw towards the left on top here. They are still doing the same thing. The deposit you can have at the first menu here by the left is the one that will show you the information about all your deposits. all the plans you have registered into, it's possible for you to register into as many possible, as many plans as possible, and as many deposits in each plan as possible. This is where you can see the information. Then the transaction will let you to see all the transactions that you have been doing on the website. You can search to know the date in that particular page. Referrer is where you have the list of your those people that you refer to the website, and those that have made deposit, those that have not made the deposit. You see their list under the referrer. Let me show you the deposit before I just leave also. So the deposit page is here. So we have the weekly deposit. It means I don't have account on weekly deposit. That's why this one is showing red. Then on Capital Back. On Capital Back, it means I have. It means I have account on Capital Back. Sorry. On weekly deposit, I have some account. No. Okay. Yes, weekly deposit, I was having some account, but they have dropped. The amount has completed and they have dropped, and that's why I don't have deposit, but I have some amounts that I've already deposited there. Then on the Capital Back, I was having account there, but they have already completed their term and I don't have them on there on the place again. But I have active on a lifetime. That's why you don't see red on this lifetime plan. Some people used to be confused about which date did they deposit. If you click here, you can see the date that I deposited each amount here. At the same time, you can see the number of days that left. Well, if it is on lifetime, as you see, minus in front of them means that the number of days that you have used on the lifetime. If it is on Capital Back, you see the normal day, but I don't have active Capital Back and I don't have active weekly deposit. That's about this one. Then the transaction page, if you click on the transaction page, you can be able to see the information. You can see the information about this month only. If you want to see previous month, you have to select the month, like maybe say May. Select the date you want, and you select when you want to head, and you now click search. So you'll be able to give you the information about the particular date you want to search for. I hope you are getting information, that information like that. Setting is where you need to first of all to edit your information, to add some information, your address, your city, next of kin information, and so forth on and so forth. You put those information that are not yet there, put them there, and make sure you click change account data to save them. I hope that one is clear. Before I move to how to transfer to member and how to withdraw to members. How to withdraw your from your wallet.